Welcome to M-Coding, where we try to get just a little bit better at programming every episode so that we can have an excuse for writing on the window with dry erase markers. I'm James Murphy, available for Python consulting. Check me out at mcoding.io. There's one feature of Python that has not aged well. So poorly, in fact, that even Python's creator, Guido van Rossum, wishes that it was never added to the language. That feature? The else clause of for and while loops. Unlike if-else, for-else and while-else are very uncommonly used. Honestly, comment now if you've never heard of these before. So first off, what does this else clause actually do? The else clause of a for or while is triggered after the loop terminates normally, meaning without a break or exception. So in both of these cases, it'll print 012 done. Whereas in either of these cases, it'll just print 01 and then it will not print done. Also, if there are no elements to loop over, this is still considered a normal end of the for or while loop. So the else will still be executed in both of these cases. By now, I hope that you're asking yourself something along the lines of, okay, why is this called else? I mean, if something else something makes sense, for something else something or while something else something, what does that really mean? And why does it correspond to this behavior of executing if there was no break or exception? Way back in the day, Python was much less popular and it was not expected to be the only programming language that you knew. It was basically understood that anyone using Python was already familiar with C or C++, and in particular, how compilers implemented while loops in C or C++. In C and C++, a while loop could just be implemented in terms of an if check with the same corresponding condition and a go-to statement. You'd label just before the start of the loop, evaluate the condition, run the body of the loop, and then go back to the start to repeat the loop. So believe it or not, the else in Python's while else is actually this else in the if go-to implementation of a while loop. If there was a break in the while loop, that would correspond to a go-to to the corresponding end label. At the time, it was expected that this would be intuitive to users. That idea obviously didn't age that well. But like it or not, in modern Python, that is what it means. And likewise, the else in for else was meant for consistency with while. Alternatively, you could think about it in terms of how fors are implemented in terms of whiles. So there's the first annoyance. The modern Python programmer doesn't really think about for and while loops in terms of go-tos. Python doesn't even have a go-to that's accessible to you. There was at some point some discussion that maybe it should just be called no break instead of else. This is clearer and more in line with what it does, so there'd be way less confusion around it, but at this point we can't really change the else. For reasons we're about to talk about, you shouldn't really be using this anyway, but if you do choose to use the else clause, at the very least include a comment to help jog the reader's memory. So theoretically, when might you actually be tempted to use this? The most common situation that I see is to avoid a single extra quote-unquote unnecessary flag variable. Here we have a simple index implementation. Index takes in a sequence like a list and a target value and tells you where in the list that value is, at what index. We create a found flag to tell us whether or not we've found the target element. Then we loop over the sequence. If we find the value, then we set found to true and break. Then at the end, we either raise or return the index that we found the element at. The value of found at the end of the loop is always equal to whether or not we broke out of the loop. Since we can detect whether we broke out of the loop using a for else, we technically don't need the found variable. Not found is just when we broke out of the loop normally, so we can just use else. Cleaner and simpler, right? Well, simpler than that other implementation, but why don't we just take this return and put it right where the break is? Then we don't need an else at all. And this is the second major reason why for else and while else have aged so poorly. The vast majority of the time, you can get rid of a for else or while else just by refactoring. Take your loop that you were going to break out of, pull it out into a function like what we have here, and replace breaks with returns. Of course, it's not always possible. I know you can probably come up with something, but in the vast majority of cases, it is possible. And it's the same story for the while else. You know, writing this example, I actually realized how little I actually use while loops. I pretty much always think in terms of containers and iterables and things that you use with for loops. Okay, so here's a situation, besides while true, which I do use, that a while loop is actually better suited than a for loop. I start out at some time and want to do work for 5 seconds. While the current time, is less than the target time, I do some work, and then I sleep for a little bit. Let's just suppose that at some time there's a possibility of some random error occurring. Not an exception, just some way of detecting that an error has happened. We break out of the loop if an error occurs, and once again, we use a flag to keep track of whether or not we broke out of the loop. Then we can either handle the error or print out a done message. If we run it, we see working, 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 and then after 3 seconds, we hit an error and handle the error. Once again, theoretically, this error flag is unnecessary, and we can get rid of it using a while else. We do that like this. If there was no break, that means no error, so we just print our done message and return. If there was a break, then we skip the return and handle the error. Personally, I think this is way less readable. I would prefer to just have the error flag. All this is done in the name of performance, but this is going to be a huge readability cost for what extra performance, really? Saving one extra Boolean? The performance benefit is going to be minuscule at best, if you can even measure it. The only time something like this could make a difference is if you were doing it inside of a hot loop. And even then, the savings are still going to be less than a percent. So please join me in actively avoiding for else and while else. Personally, I rarely see for else actually used, and I have not once ever seen while else used in production code. Although even the creator of Python thinks that it was a bad idea that it was ever put into the language in the first place, it's probably never going to be removed. That would be a major backwards incompatibility requiring a Python 4.0 release. From the Python 2 to Python 3 transition, the Python community already learned how much of a hassle this is. So in the future, it's unlikely that it'll get removed, but there are still some things that I would recommend for you. Of course, stop using it and tell your friends and coworkers to stop using it, and politely suggest to your DevOps or Python infrastructure team to either turn on or create a linter rule to prevent you from doing this. If you'd like to hear more about creating your own linter rules, check out my video on the topic. And finally, I just want to say that all this bad stuff about else's is only for for else and while else. I have nothing against if else or try except else. In fact, I think try except else is actually very underutilized. Anyway, and as always, thank you for watching. Don't forget to like the video, comment, and subscribe for more Python content. Special thanks to my patrons and donors for supporting me. I really appreciate the support. If you especially like my content, please consider becoming a patron or donor.